Hello, this is a new comfy UI workflow tutorial. In this tutorial, I want to demonstrate a workflow I've been working on for quite a while. This workflow will use a avatar image or image-to-image technique and then transform that into a 3D model. So we're using a fast stable diffusion for the model, 3D model, and we're actually having two parts. So we're having the 2D workflow, which is all of this. And then we have the 3D workflow, which will be this part. And you can toggle different workflow components with this fast group bypass node. So in here we're using a depth model as well. In this case, we're using depth anything version 2. Also, I worked on the face analysis part as well, where I have face detection crop node, which is this one. I had some problems with maintaining the input colors from the input image. So it will basically find the face and crop out this area where it sees the face and then save it as a 1024 times 1024 image size for the output. We're then masking out the face with this part. I'm using an LLM plugin, custom node plugin. You can find everything here. So with the manager installed, you can use custom node manager, and you can search for any node that you want to install. I installed this one. So just hit install, and it will give you a decent prompt for the input image. So I like this model also, MiniCPMV and Moondream. The image shows a close-up of the face of a woman with striking blue eyes and long black hair. Fitting. Yeah, it describes this input image pretty well. These are just model loaders, so you can toggle between input 1 or 2. This will use, one will use FluxDev, the original one, and this one will use FluxDev quantized version for Q8. Shout out to Nerdy Rodent. I copied this part from his workflow. What else? So we have a bunch of stuff here also with the guidance and control nets. We're using a control net here, which is actually the control net union. It's a pretty good model. It combines all the control nets into one gigantic model. So pretty, it's useful. So after generation, we do some noise injection here. I have a random seed generator, which I've created as well. And yeah, there's also memory optimization because I ran into issues with the memory maxing out on my 24 gigabyte memory card. So let's give this a try. We can use another input image. Let's try with this image, see how this performs. So it should actually crop out the area of the face. Hopefully this will not give me any boom errors. We can see that this didn't work well. Let's try with another image. The model has problems when the images are not aligned, when the subject is not looking straight in the, into the camera. We can try it with this image. See if the face cropper works. Yes, this time it works. Cropped out the face. Let's see. So it's running the workflow here. This is quite heavy, this part. So it's sampling twice with a inject latent noise, and it's also using sun noise latent and a random seed generator attached to that. I've optimized the code for the random seed generator, so we're offloading the torch cache, CUDA cache memory into the onto the CPU. This will help mitigate the running out of memory for GPU. I hope this generation works. Let's see the result. So it's upscaling. I'm using a model here for upscale 4x NOMO 8K hat L. So you can find these models on ModelDB. I think it did a quite good job. Obviously, you can refine this image, but for the most part, I think this worked. So let's go for the second step, the 3D workflow. And we will enable this part here, and we will drop this image in here, and we'll queue up because this glitching a bit here. I think what worked for me was I clicked here onto unload models and free model and model cache, and then just try to run the workflow again. Okay, it's telling me that I'm having memory issues still. Okay, what can we do to reduce this? Try the second one, second input. Yeah, I think I'll try and restart Comfy. So the idea is actually to take this outputted mesh as an input mesh for MetaHumans. I've done some tests on that, and it kind of works, but it still needs way more precision. Let's see if we run this again. So we get a cutout. And now it's doing the 3D part. Okay, let me see if I have any other tasks running here. Nope. Oh, let's leave it as it was. Okay, this time it did work. But the texture is a bit weird. So let's try for output two. Actually, I have more images here. I'll choose this one. No, sorry. This is not the generated image. Just finding that input folder. So let's try this face. These are all faces I've generated before. And here it kind of works, but not that well. Let's try input one. Well, the head is a bit flat, so you basically need you need some kind of profile, right? I think this is the best image for demoing 3D faces. Yeah, so this is how it looks. You can see the lips don't work that well, but all in all, it's definitely making progress, the 2D to 3D workflow in terms of avatar creation. Let me know what you think. You can find this workflow on my Patreon. There's also links in the description to my GitHub where most of these workflows are for free. But if you have a member subscription, you can get these workflows. Also, I'm thinking about putting it on Gumroad as well. Thanks so much for your time. Thanks for watching, and let me know what you think. Hope to see you in the next video. Goodbye. So here's another example from 2D to 3D. This workflow does require a bit of free RAM, and what helped for me was unloading the model, free model and node cache, and then also restarting your Comfy UI. So this is a quite interesting result. As a stylized avatar creator, this does work quite well already. So here's another example. This is the input image, and I played around with the settings to use half precision to false, and this is the output mesh, which I think is quite decent. Still, it's low poly, but I think for stylized avatars, this could work well. Let's switch the input, run this again. Okay, this is for foreground ratio of 0.51. You can see it smooths it out a bit. We'll definitely have a look in Blender how these models look and perform when rendered. I have another workflow that will scale up or enhance the UV mat, so you can use this as a texture in Blender to enhance the overall look, and then finally import that into Unreal and create your Meta Human from this. That's basically the idea. Okay, so I hope you found this useful. See you next time. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.